Hello and welcome to EPG Patshala. This is Professor G. Srinivas Reddy, retired professor, Kakti University. Today we shall be discussing about Henry Fayol as an administrative thinker. You must be aware that administrative thinkers are those people who deeply thought about what is administration or how administration should be, what are the problems of administration, and how to generalize about administration. These are the things which are done by administrative thinkers. We have a large number of administrative thinkers and we try to divide them into various schools of thought. The first school of thought in public administration is known as classical theory. The second theory is known as neoclassical theory. The third is behavioral or modern theories. So this is the sequence in which administrative theories have come into being. Today we are discussing about one major thinker, namely Henry Fayol, who was very popular as a mining engineer in France. Fayol is considered to be the father of a particular approach to public administration or theory of administration known as administrative management approach. In this lecture or lesson, we shall try to have a brief biodata of Henry Fayol, some of his writings on management or administration, and his basic ideas on what is administration, a little criticism of what is on his ideas, and finally, I'll sum up what all has been presented in this course of this lecture, raise some questions, and then provide some answers. This is the sequence in which we try to understand Henry Fayol. Henry Fayol was born in the year 1841 in a French middle-class family. He did his graduation in mining engineering. He started his career in the year 1860 in a mining company, and he rose very quickly to very high positions, and in the year 1888 he became the managing director of the same company, and he retired from that company in the year 1918. He lived for 84 years, made number of seminal, very important contributions. His contributions are there both in the fields of engineering and also in the field of public administration. He has authored 10 books on engineering and number of papers and books on public administration. Henry Fayol can be compared with F.W. Taylor, about whom you will come to know separately in another lecture and lesson. Henry Fayol contributed to the administrative management, whereas Taylor contributed to work management. Let me just mention, administrative management, there are two areas of management. Management at the top level, management at the lower levels. Management at top level is known as administrative management. Management at the lower level is known as work management. Administrative management deals with the operations and activities of higher level officers, the top level, the top brass of any organization. Whereas work management deals with workers, the individual employees, the low placed employees who actually do the various jobs of a company or a government department. Taylor made contributions to lower levels, whereas Fayol made contributions to higher levels. So therefore, these two thinkers are considered to be complementary to each other. Together, they contribute to understanding of administration both at the higher levels and lower levels. Henry Fayol wrote his book relating to public administration under the title Administration Industriali et Generali. This is the French title, which was translated into English under the title General and Industrial Administration. Since Henri Fayol wrote first in French, the ideas of Fayol did not attract much attention outside the French-speaking areas. It may be informed that around the time when he was writing, the British Empire was its zenith and most of the countries were ruled by the British. English became truly the international language. So therefore, when his French writings were translated into English, it attracted attention of the whole world. Fayol wrote about number of things. Firstly, his ideas relate to administrative theory. According to him, administrative theory is universal. Fayol made no distinction between administration and management. People thought that management relates to corporate or private sector, administration relates to public sector. But Fayol believed that administration and management are one and the same. There is no need for distinction between administration and management. He further believed, like Woodrow Wilson, about whom we would have discussed somewhere else separately, he said that administration is administration no matter it is in business or in government. The administrative problems are same everywhere. This is the first contribution of Henri Fayol. The second important contribution of Henri Fayol is the elements or activities of an organization. He raised the question, what are the activities performed by an organization? He says an industrial organization performs six distinct kind of activities. And they are technical activities, commercial activities, financial activities, security activities, accounting activities, and finally, managerial activities. I would like to underscore the word managerial activities. So therefore, according to Henri Fayol, managerial activities are one among six broad groups of activities. An organization does so many activities, and some of these activities are managerial activities. From here, he goes to the next question as to what are the managerial activities. The managerial activities, according to Fayol, are five. These five activities are, Henri Fayol talked about the various activities performed by an organization, and as we have already discussed, the last activities relate to management. The managerial activities are conveyed through an acronym, A-C-R-O-N-Y-M. Acronym means a coined word. In this coined word, there are five letters and they are capital P, O, C, C, C. P, O, C, C, C. Each of the letter here stands for one of the activities of management. Students, if you are interested in knowing what management is, I think here Henri Fayol has provided a very short and simple way of knowing and remembering what management activities are. The first activity of management is planning. Planning is looking before leaping. Planning is taking care of future requirements, making advance preparations. This is one of the important activities of a manager. A successful manager is also a successful planner. So therefore, the first activity is ability to plan. So all managers have to learn how to plan well and execute those plans properly. The second important activity is organizing. Organizing is dividing the work and assigning to people depending on what their abilities are, or building an organizational structure and making authority responsibility divisions among people. Next important thing is commanding. A manager cannot get things done sitting pretty in his chair. He has to give various kinds of orders or communications to his subordinates, invoking them, asking them to do various jobs. This job is called commanding. The next important job is coordinating. Coordination is bringing various elements of work to a common platform so that they yield some final result. Coordination is ensuring cooperation. Coordination is preventing conflicts. Coordination is orderly synchronization of efforts, sequencing of efforts, and coordination is leaving no gaps in work and avoiding duplication of work. So this is another important activity that managers have to do. And finally, the last C in POCCC is controlling an organization. Controlling is confirming events to plans. So the first activity and the last activity are interrelated. What you plan, you have to achieve. If you are achieving what is planned, you have control. Controlling is holding the steering, as in a vehicle, and navigating a car or a vehicle in the direction in which you want to go. If the car is not going on the right direction, that's what you say, you have lost control. Maybe when you lose control, you may meet with an accident. So therefore, the whole organization has to be steered by the manager towards the particular direction. This kind of thing is known as controlling. After this, the next important contribution made by Henry Fayol is the principles of management. Let me just mention that principles are the universals of management. I've mentioned that Henry Fayol is an important contributor to the classical theory of administration or classical theory of management. One thing common to various thinkers of the classical type is that they all believed that administration and management are universal, and administration management must be based on some sound principles. Let me just mention that a principle is a universal truth. A principle is one with the help of which you can achieve your results. If you want to have economy and efficiency, these are the goals of classical thinkers. These thinkers try to ensure efficiency and economy in the organizations. If you want to have efficiency or economy, you have to follow certain principles. Henry Fayol, I think all the thinkers of the classical category, Henry Fayol, F.W. Taylor, Luther Gulick, Linda Lurwick, Mooney, Reilly, all these people have their own principles of organization or management. Henry Fayol has listed some 14 principles of management. And he said that these principles are important. Whether it is an industrial organization or government organization, these are the essential things. These are the universal things. Without them, organization cannot function efficiently or economically. The first of these principles is division of work. Division of work is important for the success of the organization. An organization comes into being only when one individual cannot achieve all the things. We all know that all of us have limitations, both physical, mental, or intellectual. We cannot do everything on our own. So therefore, there is need for people. And people are an essential part of organization. When people are there, work has to be divided. And in fact, if you look at the human being, who is one of the beings in the living world, one thing that distinguishes human beings from all other beings, animals and other living beings, is that there is an extreme division of work in human body. Human body has different systems for different things. For eating something, digesting something, for giving immunity something, for carrying energy to various parts of the body, there is another system. So therefore, there is a minute division of work in the human body. Therefore, human being is able to control the whole universe. Division of work is very important to ensure the work is light and ensure separation and specialization and all that. So this is the first principle of division, first principle of management. Let me just restate. The principle is division of work. Next important principle is authority and responsibility. In every organization, there shall be authority and responsibility. And organization comes into being only when authority and responsibility are divided among the people. Authority is the authorization to do something. Authority enables a person to achieve things, achieve results, carry out activities. But when authority is there, the principle says that authority and responsibility must be matching. If somebody has authority and has no responsibility, the person may behave irresponsibly. He may become authoritarian. Conversely, if the person is given responsibility, you are asked to, you are responsible for this, but you are not given authority, you will become ineffective. So authority without responsibility makes you authoritarian, high-handed. Responsibility without authority makes you ineffective. So therefore, there should be judicious mix of authority and responsibility, and both of them should go hand in hand. The third important thing is discipline. It is said that the chief strength of army is not the numbers, but the discipline. If there are two countries fighting war with each other, which country wins perhaps depends on the discipline of the armed forces than the number of men and women working in the army. So discipline is very important for organization. A disciplined organization is one which follows rules and regulations. A disciplined organization is one where people apply themselves energetically for the task. Discipline also means applying oneself very seriously and energetically to the tasks that are given. A person who is sitting passively, a person who is doing things without interest, is also indisciplined. Indiscipline is not merely violating the orders of the superior. Indiscipline also means not doing things very seriously. So therefore, discipline is very important, and without discipline, there will be confusion and there will be chaos in the organization. The fourth important principle listed out by Henry Fayol is unity of command. Unity of command means, unity literally means one. Command means order. For any organization, there should be one commander. There should not be two commanders. It's a matter of common sense, and we all know that too many cooks spoil the broth. A broth is an item, the menu that is prepared. And if there are two cooks cooking the same dish, one cook may add salt or avoid adding salt, thinking that the other person has added or not added. The result would be that too much of salt or no salt at all, and the dish will be spoiled. So therefore, unity of command says that every organization should be headed by one individual only. There should not be duplicity of commander or duplicity of command. The next important principle, or fifth principle, is unity of direction. Unity of direction means clear direction. There are some executives or managers who are very confused. They say something and they say things contrary to that a short while later. This is not correct. The direction should be very clear, unequivocal, and it should be very clear to the person who is taking the command. Unity of direction makes people walk or do things in single file so that the energy of the organization is not dissipated. People don't work at cross purposes. So this principle is equally important. The sixth principle of management and organization is subordination of individual interest to general interest. Let me just clarify what is individual interest and general interest. Individual interest is personal interest. Now, if somebody is working in a government department or a business organization, there may be so many people working. Everybody, after all, has, everybody will have their own interests. బట్ వైల్ వర్కింగ్ ఫర్ ద ఆర్గనైజేషన్ దే షుడ్ కీప్ అసైడ్ దర్ పర్సనల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ అండ్ వర్క్ ఫర్ కలెక్టివ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్. ది కలెక్టివ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఇస్ ది ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆర్గనైజేషన్. సో ది ఐడియా ఇస్ దట్ పీపుల్ షుడ్ నాట్ థింక్ ఆఫ్ దర్ పర్సనల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్, దే షుడ్ సబార్డినేట్ దర్ పర్సనల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ టు ఆర్గనైజేషన్. వన్ మే ఆస్క్ ది క్వశ్చన్, హౌ అబౌట్ ది ఫెలో, యు నో, ఇస్ ఇట్ రియలీ పాసిబుల్ ఫర్ ఎన్ ఇండివిజువల్ టు ఫర్గెట్ టోటలీ అబౌట్ హిస్ సెల్ఫ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్? ఓకే, వన్ మే నాట్ ఫర్గెట్, బట్ వన్ షుడ్ రిమెంబర్ దట్ యూ కెనాట్ థింక్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్, పర్సనల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఆల్ ద టైమ్ వర్కింగ్ ఇన్ ద ఆర్గనైజేషన్. ది సెల్ఫ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ విల్ బి టేకెన్ కేర్ ఆఫ్ బై ఫాలోయింగ్ ది కామన్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్. ఇఫ్ యూ పర్సూ ది కామన్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్, ఇఫ్ ద ఆర్గనైజేషన్ మీట్స్ ఇట్స్ గోల్స్ అండ్ ద ఆర్గనైజేషన్ హ్యాస్ వేస్ ఆఫ్ రివార్డింగ్ ది ఇండివిజువల్ ఆల్సో ఫర్ ది గుడ్ వర్క్ హీ హాస్ డన్, సో దేర్ ఫోర్ వాట్స్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఈస్ దట్ పీపుల్ షుడ్ నాట్ థింక్ టూ మచ్ అబౌట్ దర్ పర్సనల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ వెన్ దే ఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఫర్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్స్. దే హ్యావ్ టు ఆల్ ద టైమ్ థింక్ అబౌట్ ది ఆర్గనైజేషనల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ యాజ్ లాంగ్ యాజ్ దే ఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఇన్ ది ఆర్గనైజేషన్. ద నెక్స్ట్ సెవెంత్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ ఈస్ రెమ్యునరేషన్. రెమ్యునరేషన్ ఈస్ ద పర్సన్ హూ ఈస్ వర్కింగ్. ఐ థింక్ దీస్ డేస్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈజ్ మానిటైజ్డ్. There were times, maybe 2-3 centuries back, people would get something free from, there used to be free floating resources. If you want to have some material, you could just use it, lift it, take it and consume it. But today it's not possible. Everything is priced and therefore people require money to survive. So organization should take care of the pecuniary or monetary interests of individuals, and this is covered under salary administration and all that. And saints and sadhus will not make an organization these days. There may be people with saintly nature, but absolute saint cannot fit into organizations. After all, there are people with families and responsibilities and all that. Therefore, to take care of that, they should be paid salaries and all. Next important principle is centralization. Centralization is giving, moving authority to higher echelons or higher levels of the organization. Centralization is boss having lot of authority, subordinates not having much authority. The reverse of this is known as decentralization. So the principle states that all important things should be centralized so that the boss knows which is important, which is not important. The next important thing is the ninth principle, scalar chain. Scalar chain is more commonly known as hierarchy. It says that organization should not comprise of equals. If in an organization everybody is equal, suppose everybody is a manager, everybody is an assistant manager, I think nobody would listen to the other fellow because they are all equal. There should be some superior, there should be a subordinate, and subordinate should have some more subordinates. So therefore, in an organization, depending on their abilities, their importance, the nature of work, people should be graded into various levels and they should be interrelated. This process of linking all the people in an organization in a chain of command is known as scalar chain. This is also known as hierarchy. Hierarchy literally means hierarchy, rule by the higher over the lower fellow. So this gives a kind of integration to the organization. If anybody is doing something, I think it's important for an organization to move towards one common goal that can be achieved by a common superior. There are chances that when number of people are working, each will pursue one's own line. One goes eastwards, one goes westwards, one goes north and southwards. Now, how to bring them onto one direction is achieved by this hierarchy or scalar chain. The 10th principle is order. Order is everything has a place. Now, there should not be a round speck in the square hole. People have different abilities, people have different capabilities, and people should be right person in the right place is what the order is. There should be orderliness in the organization. The 11th principle is equity or equity. Equity is different from equality. Equality is giving same treatment to everybody. Equity is giving different treatments to different people depending on what they deserve. Now, reservation system, which gives job reservations to SCs, STs or OBCs, is an example of equity and not equality. Here, everybody cannot compete for the jobs which are reserved for these communities. And these communities are given reservations because of the centuries-old backwardness. So this is an example of equity. Equity is giving better treatment to somebody who is handicapped, somebody who received lesser treatment earlier. So equity is a means for achieving equality. So equality is the goal, equity is the means. This is thing, and equity says that a boss or a manager should treat employees equitably. A good performer has to be singled out for good treatment. A bad performer perhaps has to be given bad treatment. This is a question of equity. And the 12th principle is stability. Stability of tenure of people. In an organization, these days, in many private sector organization, there is a terrible problem of attrition. Attrition is people leaving jobs. People are not sticking to jobs. Stability says that in an organization, you don't transfer people frequently. Say, for example, you are shifting an employee or clerk or a supervisor or somebody else. Every month you are changing his seat. It's not the way to conduct an organization. You have to ensure some stability of tenure, so that people learn things. Now, people don't learn things overnight and they don't become perfect. So, therefore, you have to give stability of tenure to people. The 13th principle is initiative. Initiative is taking lead in something. Initiative is cutting ice. Initiative is ability to think innovatively. Now, administration can achieve its goals by thinking out of the box, by thinking in novel ways. And this principle is important for the success of an organization. There should be initiative in the organization. There should not be passiveness in the organization. People should give leads. People should think innovatively. People should do things in novel ways so that organization can go forward in unconventional ways. And the last thing is, Esprit is course, Espiritdecorps. This is called the spirit of camaraderie. We all know that unity is strength. The haystack, if they are handled singly, they will break easily. If they are woven into a rope, I think it can bind a mighty elephant also. So therefore, when even feeble people, weak people, people who are not very capable, they all marshal their energies, they come together, they can become very strong and achieve the purposes. So the 14th principle essentially is the principle of teamwork. I think some of the modern business organizations are shifting from individual based work to team based work. So there should be team spirit in the organization. Members of the organization should think that they're all working for one common purpose. And the common purpose perhaps is the profit for business or the service to people, depending on which type of organization you are talking. And this common purpose should permeate everybody, and they should join hands, and they should not work at cross purposes. Team building, of course, is complex, but there is no way. You have to iron out all the differences. You have to bring everybody to same level of thinking and same orientation and same perception of objectives of the organization. Well, these are the 14 principles of organization and management mentioned by Henry Fayol. And Henry Fayol says that following these is very important. Let me mention that in the classical thinkers, the students of public administration may wonder, if they look at the background of the thinkers who are making contributions, Woodrow Wilson was a political scientist. Henry Fayol was a mining engineer. F.W. Taylor was a mechanical engineer. Now, these are all engineers and other kind of people making contributions to administration or public administration. And why these people have made contributions, or how these people could make contribution, is because of the fact that administration is administration. the knowledge gained running an industry, the knowledge gained running a business is found useful in running a government also. Two more things that Henry Fayol has emphasized have to be mentioned to make the lecture complete. One of them is the need and importance of training. Henry Fayol was one of the earliest to realize about the importance of training. Training has to be given to every employee, that's what he said. And particularly every supervisor has to be trained, and every supervisor has to train the subordinates. He believed in the value of training. Training is nothing but giving some kind of knowledge, job relevant skills, and molding the attitudes of the people so that they will do the jobs well. So training has three purposes. One is knowledge giving, second is skill giving, and thirdly, shaping up the attitudes. So these things are important, and therefore Henry Fayol said that training should have an important place in running organizations. Finally, Henry Fayol talks about the importance of formal organization. Let me just mention that organizations can be of two types. Some of them are known as formal organizations, some of them are known as informal organizations. A formal organization is an official organization. An organization as it is shown in an organization chart, organization that is built through the orders of the officers and all that. Formal organization is well structured. Formal organization is one about which a lot of deliberation thinking takes place, and people decide who should be the top and how many levels should be there, who should be subordinate and all that. This kind of structure is known as formal organization. Informal organization is actually a set of interpersonal relations that develop over a period of time. People while working in an organization will have two kinds of relations. One is formal or official relations. The second is unofficial relations. One good example of official relation is relation between boss and subordinate. Whenever the subordinate meets the boss, as in India, I think the fellow would start greeting him, good morning sir, good evening sir, and all that. The subordinate has to receive, wait for orders from the superior. He has to listen to what the superior says with rapt attention. This is the kind of relation. Informal relation is cutting across lines of hierarchy. Informal relations are relations that come up because of shared common interests, mutual interests. Both employees, maybe a boss and subordinate, are interested in movies, and the subordinate is narrating about a particular movie he would have watched the day before. I think the boss listens to him. This kind of communication is called informal communication or informal organization. Now, what Henry Fayol is saying is that formal organization is very important. The official organization has to be respected. The official organization is important. And contrary to this, there is another writer or thinker whose contributions we will discuss separately. George Elton Mayo, who is considered to be the father of human relations, he emphasized on the importance of informal relations or informal organization. Well, these are some of the important contributions of Henry Fayol. Henry Fayol, a French mining engineer, he served in mining engineering industry, and he has written number of books on engineering, but he has also made contributions to general management, and his work was originally there in French language. It got translated into English. His basic contribution is to administrative management or top level or boardroom level management, in contrast to Taylor's contribution of work management or worker level management. Now, coming to a little criticism on this, Henry Fayol says there are 14 principles of management. If you follow them, management will be efficient and economic. But the fact of the matter is that just by following these principles, will the things really work out, and will the organizations achieve profits or render the services for which they are meant? Now, some people say this is not so. After all, what is very important or equally important is that the people in the organization. Now, the people's motivation. Mere principles are there, work is divided, hierarchy is created, everything is done. But people, two people working in on the same shop floor and the same office, they are not meeting eye to eye. They don't talk to each other. There is no cooperation between them. They have to work together, but they are not working. So organization fails. So therefore, there is a very important element missing in this. The classical thinkers, by and large, including Henry Fayol, has given importance to the structural elements or the formal aspects. There are so many informal aspects that are important, and the importance of informal aspects is stressed by the neoclassical thinkers like George Elton Mayer, whose theory is also popular as human relations theory. And when we discuss that lecture, I think we'll come to know more about this. So therefore, one limitation of the classical theory in general and Henry Fayol's contribution in particular is that mere following the principles is no guarantee that administration will be efficient. Well, here I close my lecture and we'll take up one or two questions. One question will be, what is the place of Henry Fayol in the field of public administration or management? Now, the answer is that Henry Fayol has made contribution to both the subjects of general management and also to public administration. And his contribution is there because he believed, he made no distinction between the industrial administration and general administration. He believed that administration is administration, principles are principles. So possibly one may have a doubt whether the same principle, I think depending on the nature of organization, right, in public administration, hierarchy is very important, unit of command is very important. And these principles are very important in police departments, military departments, where quick decision making is needed, or in a fire service department. But in development departments, in Panchayat Raj institutions, India is a classic example where there are two kinds of hierarchies, multiple hierarchies, but yet results are coming. So, okay, this has to be seen in that direction. And Henry Fayol has a lasting place in administrative theory. He is an eminent administrative thinker. He is considered to be the father of administrative theory, particularly the boardroom level theory or the administrative management theory. And his ideas are based on his practical experience. And he has converted a French mining company, which was under deep losses, into one of the most profitable companies. In fact, people paid compliments to him, saying that his tenure as the chief executive of that particular company was one of the romances in French mining industry. It was a romantic chapter, a great achievement. So Henry Fayol was a practitioner. Based on his practical ideas and personal experience, he has developed some theories, and therefore its value cannot be disputed. These are not mere armchair theories. It's not some professor sitting in his room, cozy room, and spinning theories. He was one who had solid personal experience on the basis of which he was making contributions, and therefore the ideas of Henry Fayol have a lot of importance. Here we close. Thank you